Ouais, philosophie.
Is it a way of life? I wouldn't go that far, but it certainly takes up a lot of time. Here in Geneva, we train 3 times a week. Although it's not exactly top-level sport because there's no specific training program. We don't work on our fitness more than any other aspect or anything, but the speed and rhythm during a game, it's pretty intense.
C'est intense, quoi. Et je trouvais ça ridicule, en fait, comme...
My first reaction was, what a ridiculous idea for a sport. I asked myself how people could do something so stupid. But when you turn up and you've got a bike, you're encouraged to have a go. When we were starting out, there weren't many players, so we certainly took the time to welcome new people. The general level was pretty poor, so beginners could get their bearings quite quickly and become part of the group. It's really addictive because not only is it a team sport, but there's also the equipment side of it. If you like bikes and fiddling around with them and so on.
C'est un aspect matériel, si on aime le vélo, si on aime la bricole et tout ça.
One day you play, the next you fix your bike. You play, you fix. That's how you really get caught up in it. This is the mallet for the final.
The first time I came, I asked Laurent for an inner tube. He told me they didn't have any. The idea was that they repaired and reused stuff rather than buying new.
My life revolves around bikes. I've worked with them for more than 10 years now. I was a mechanic in a little workshop for 5 or 6 years, and I've been a courier for 4.
Là, ça fait 4 ans que je suis coursier.
The bike couriering world is very corporate, so you stay together quite a lot. You're always developing new things on your bike or trying things out. In fact, that's also how people get into bike polo.
Et puis, bah, c'est comme ça qu'on s'est mis au polo aussi, en fait. Quand c'est en tournoi, ça peut devenir vraiment tendu.
Tournaments can get really tense, you know. Some people pull some pretty nasty moves. The problem is that there aren't really any established rules. And as a result, the competitors are also the referees. And some matches with certain teams or players can get a bit spicy. Things are becoming more physical. It's not out of the question for players to get a mallet in the face. I've seen some get really messed up.
Assez violent et qu'on finit vraiment amoché.
My nickname, which started off as my virtual personality, my virtual ego, is Eddie Marx, a combination of legendary Belgian cyclist Eddie Merckx and Karl Marx.